Okay. So then we got the Three of Cups here and the Seven of Cups. Three of Cups, Seven of Cups. Yes. Three of Cups, Seven of Cups. A friend. This is a friend or a companion wanting you to lose everything. They wanted you to lose everything. But what ended up happening is you became the Page of Coins. That's fucked up. That's so fucked up. That's greedy. Body. This involving somebody's body. This friend was jealous because of your body. That's sick as fuck. Okay. This friend thought that because of the great health, well, and that is the case. Your health and all things are the reason you have a great body, male or female. You have a very great body, and that's what this stemmed from. Your body. This has nothing to do with who you are, where you be, anything like that. It has to do with your body. These people think that your body is getting you to these places. Not that you're having sex with people. These people know that men or women look at your body and know that they want you 100%. These people tried to put you through these hurdles and all of this shit. They did this, all the betrayals and shit. They did all of this shit, right, collective? So that you can fuck up your body. Start using drugs. Start using alcohol. Y'all know when women drink, you know why women's bodies be so flabby. Like, women, they have hips and shit when they're young and they get old and their hips get flabby and shit because they've been drinking. They've been drinking and not working out. They've been drinking and not detoxing and stuff. When a body starts to sag out like that, that's from drinking. Or in my situation, because you sit down and get fucking fat. But anyway, go. It shouldn't be going like that. These individuals wanted you to mess up your body. They wanted, and I mean, they wanted you to get skinny. These individuals don't want you to use somebody with weight to your body. And if you ain't got weight to your body, these individuals keep you going through confusion, keep things active in your life so that you don't have the time to sit down and indulge and eat. Ten of Swords, whoever this is, they sit down and think of ways to irritate you. These people can even make fake pages. They follow you on their real page and come back in on fake pages, collective. The Heyyy, yes. The numbers 5 could be significant. It's somebody that's head in charge of this shit, like. You pissed off the main bitch, the main nigga. Like, somebody part of the group don't like you. They don't like your energy. These people don't invite you nowhere. But they act like they're your friends. They don't invite you nowhere, nothing like that, because they're actually scared of you in person, because they don't know if you know that they were the reason of your failure. And they're most scared now because you come back so powerful. Look, Page of Swords. You've come back more powerful than you've ever been. Ten of Cups, balance. Also, I'm getting that when these friends put you through this battle, this hermit moment, there was somebody, a secret admirer, watching. This secret admirer is now about to come to the forefront. Yep. And there's about to be a lot of the tower moments for all of these individuals. Somebody told your partner a lot of false shit about you. You know who your divine counterpart is, but somebody told this person a bunch of the tower things. They caused the tower split in between this relationship, a friendship caused the tower. Like I said, your body. This friend could have been saying that you use your toe, just the emperor, or the empress, that you use your body for your Ten of Cup balance, but that's not completely it. This person is just upset that your body is really fucking crazy. Look, Six of Coins. This person, this friend group, this friend knew that whoever this the emperor was would be willing to give to you and take care of you. This person could have actually liked it. Look, Three of Swords upside down. This person could have actually, this friend could have actually liked that you're the emperor. And this could have been a friend group. And when it told this the emperor something to cause the tower moment. And at one point, this the emperor and you were tight. And it was about to become a relationship or some shit. It was a friendship that you didn't even see about to take off into a relationship, right? This friend went behind your back and said something. And it made this individual, like, no, like, step back from you, right? But when this individual stepped back from you, they were in their blessing. This person is always in a tip of the cup moment, right? This is a divine masculine. This divine masculine decided to step back out of your energy. So when this divine masculine stepped back out of your energy, this divine masculine stepped back and took all the things that God was giving you through them. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because this friend knew that this, the emperor, this divine masculine was about to put you in a six of coins moment. So this friend went and put a seven of cups moment over you to the point where you began to lose everything. Not because you wasn't stable, you wasn't focused, but because you were not supposed to be taking care of that situation. Whatever situation happened to you, collective, you weren't supposed to be taking care of that. This, the emperor, this divine masculine, divine female, the empress, your counterpart was supposed to be taking care of that. But this disgusting, hateful, envious friend group, I'm getting, this is two or three. Two of them really don't like you. And that's the tower right here. These two right here in this tower, they really do not like you. Two of these friends. And one of them could just be around in a friend group. But two of these friends are about to have a major the tower. One of these friends you may actually be in good standings with. But two of these individuals that bear false witness upon you are about to be kicked out of tower. Their relationship with this, the emperor, is about to end. This, the emperor, could actually be their friends, and they're trying to work their way up to the girlfriend and status and shit like that, wifey status and shit. But it's not working. This masculine, divine masculine, is seeing what this, I'm getting years ago, look, magician, at a rapid speed. Years ago, this person knew that y'all did that. This divine masculine knew that females was hating on you. They didn't know that they were hating on you then, but they're starting to see it and understand it now. Because within time, all wounds heal. So now this divine masculine is able to see that whatever friend caused this, the tower moment upon you, was hating. And maybe this, the emperor, said something like they like you, they like the friend or something like that. They like that you collective, and the friend said something to make this person not want to move forward with you. This is the reason you went through all them issues. And I ain't gonna cap, whatever you went through it at a rapid speed. Like, it was left and right, uncontrollably, unstoppable, because this, the emperor, was supposed to be taking care of everything that was uncontrollable and unstoppable. Every issue that came into your life at this time, this, the emperor, you're supposed to call them, roll over next to them, and they were gonna take care of it. But this friend that put you into the hermit moment, this friend group, made this person change cold on you. And don't get me wrong, this, the emperor, God has punished this, the emperor, because this, the emperor, has had to watch you go through vulnerable moments. This person has had to sit back and watch you go through things that are indescribable. This person has also had premonitions, visions. This person is gifted the divine masculine. God has sent them dreams, visions. God will put this person to sleep to make them take a nap while they're at work, and it will be just so that God can reveal to them what you were doing at that moment to make ends meet. You get what I'm saying? Temperance. So this person has seen you in the spiritual realm at your most vulnerable, embarrassing moments. God has revealed your embarrassing moments to this person. Queen of Cups. And this person still likes you. This person is still there for you. The color blue could be significant. Birds could be special. You could wake up to birds chirping in the morning. That's because your divine partner. Just because this person knows you, their divine partner. They didn't know it at first, but they're starting to realize it now. Maybe there was some type of contact made. Maybe you contacted this person. You said something to this person. There was some sort of contact made. I'm getting that you contacted this person. Maybe it was a post on social media. Happy birthday. Happy Thanksgiving. You know, anything. Congratulations. Graduation. Look, Knight of Swords. Flew straight out. Knight of Swords. Congratulations on work, graduation, something, an elevation in this person's life. You reached out. And with the moment you reached out, they already knew. Because they had been having premonitions. They had been having feelings. Because the people, the friends that told them this information about you ain't so well themselves. You're doing better than these individuals. So this emperor just been sitting back watching the whole time. Six of Swords. This, the emperor, actually moved away. Divine masculine, this divine asking masculine, moved away from y'all hometown because it was too much to bear to be there with you and they to be there without you, and they knew that you were the person they were supposed to be with. So this person skipped town. They moved town, went to a different part of y'all state, went to a different part of y'all town, but this person is a distance away from you. I'm also getting that this person is going to travel a distance to you. The Empress. Look, I can't make this shit up. The Empress, Ten of Cups. We're going to move that to the Tower because you are no longer facing the Tower moments when it comes to your relationship life. This friend group really tried to fry your relationship. This divine masculine told this friend group, told one of these friends or somehow connected to them, that they were about to change your life for better. The Hangman. They told this friend that they were about to change your life for better in some type of way. And this friend made sure that did not happen. The numbers 34 could be significant. Six of Cups. Unforeseen event. Somebody about to ask you to marry them too. Somebody about to ask you to marry them, collective. I can't make none of this stuff. This masculine dove, whenever y'all link back up again, because y'all used to be around each other often. Now, don't get me wrong. This is somebody you have. Maybe you could have worked with this person. Look, four staff jumping the hell out. Like, four staff wants the attention. Four staff wants the attention. Let me see what Miss Cleo talking about. Hold on. Let me open up my packet. Four staff is like, it looked like somebody did like this just now. Y'all seeing it? It looked like somebody went. And Miss Cleo. Man, rest in peace to Miss Cleo. Also, the girl off of Babs. I can't remember her name. Sorry. But I remember her from Babs. She played with Halle Berry. Do y'all know she passed from colon cancer? Us pigmented people. Y'all gotta, whenever you gotta take a shit, go take a shit. Get y'all take, do y'all colon cleanse. Drink y'all teas. Us pigmented people, we gotta take care of our insides. Our outsides so strong that our insides can actually be weak. That's how us pigmented people could be sick in the inside and don't even know it because your skin is just there and healthy and surviving. Your inside is pink now. Don't get it. Your inside is pink now. Your inside is not pigmented now, baby. Make sure y'all are taking care of yourselves, my queens. Even if you ain't pigmented, my queen, make sure you is taking any time y'all got a shit. Get your ass up and go shit. I don't care if you riding a nigga. Get up and go take a shit and start that shit over. Don't play with your bowel movements and do not be having anal sex. Do not be playing with your anus. That is not what God gave it to you for. God gave you your vagina for sexual arousing to your kingdom spouse. And if a man wants your anal, that is not the spouse that God gave to you because God would have gave him to another man. Do you hear what I'm saying? Don't be playing with y'all asses. Don't be getting these BBLs, these shots. Don't be playing with y'all fucking bodies, bro. When you take a shit, wipe your ass with a wipe or a wet towel if you're not about a shower. But if you at home and you take a shit, get your ass in the shower, girl. And if you're not at home when you take a shit, improvise. Make sure you wipe. Whatever you do, make sure you're wiping yourself with warm water and a towel. And ladies, every time, you don't every time need to use soap when you get in the tub. Sometimes you can feel your body telling you, oh, you've been clean for a long time. I'm telling y'all, I'm trying to live to 300 like the Bible is. Now, y'all better tap in with me now. Y'all better get on this train now. This is why y'all don't live to 300-400 and shit no more. I'm going to be living to 500, I swear to God. Y'all better tap in now. In the Bible days, people used to live 300 to 400, 500, 600, 700, 800. Why y'all can't live that long nowadays? Because y'all playing with y'all assholes and shit. Stop doing that shit. Keep this shit traditional. Now let's get to this full staff. Rest in peace, our lost ones that will go too soon. The Miss Cleo, let's see what you talking about, because you got this full staff jumping. A card of peace of mind. Positive energy, success, easy moving, anticipated marriage, home life. Girl, come on now, Miss Keo. Come on with it. Come on. Come on with it. Keep vouching for me. That's what I'm saying. See, God is really, they mad. God gonna always make sure somebody vouching for you. God gonna always make sure it's a witness there for you. Come on with it. A great deal of positive energy is here. Success and peace are present. A marriage is indicated. This card is considered with home. So this divine masculine is about to come and bless your home. I ain't gonna cap. I ain't with inviting niggas into my home and shit. But if you know who this nigga is, you should invite him to your home because he not coming over there to fuck or do anything like that. Like, soon as homeboy walk in, he look the lovers, the devil. Yes, this was magic done. But y'all know mouthcraft gossiping? That's the devil. That's mouthcraft. Gossiping is mouthcraft. That's why it's called gossiping. Gossiping. You sipping on God's business. Gossiping. Okay? That is a form of magic. That's a form of mind and ear craft. That's called Minecraft. Just like the game Minecraft. Y'all see how that game building and playing with people mining that hole? That's just what Minecraft doing the magic round. This what this person hindered from you. This person put you in isolation, but it was good that, now you're stuck standing 10 toes tall in isolation. You stuck standing 10 toes tall in isolation, about to get you the emperor. Ain't nobody got access to you while your cup is running over, all because of this friend group that sit up there and tried to cause harm. Now listen, don't get me wrong. If this, you can say friends can't just cause all these issues. Listen. When you got a best friend that's in your business and know everything, know who you talk to on a daily, know who to tell a practitioner to hit, there's nothing you could do about it. This friend could have told, like instead of this friend telling this partner something, this divine masculine, your future partner, they could have had a magic craft send this person something, send them a bad dream about you. You get what I'm saying? But instead, this friend took it upon herself, which is that's why you get injustice. Buku balances in your life right now, collective. And I am here to tell you, to a staff, whoever said this shit about you, whoever participated in this shit here, baby, they are in a bad place in life. They are robbing Pete to pay Paul, then to give back what they borrowed from Kellyton. Are you hearing what I'm saying? This individual, these people, I'm getting two friends, and one of them hoes is your best friend, and y'all got two friends that your best friend be talking about what you talk about the friends too. Like, I'm telling you, bro, like, these bitches, and you never even thought that these bitches would say some shit like that, do some shit. This the bitches you say you taking one for the team for. I'm getting taking one for the team. Taking one for the team was funny until you finally figuring out what they mean you was taking one for the team. Your dumb ass been taking all these betrayals and setbacks in life for the team. For their friendship. For them to keep going while you stuck in poverty and shit like that. But God snatched you out of that shit quickly. And whoever this divine masculine is, he no longer trusts these individuals' words. And also, I'm getting that these friends, this friend group, whoever said this shit to this, the emperor about you, they not this, the emperor don't trust nobody associated with these friends. So if this was some type of business arrangement or something, the emperor, this divine masculine, is no longer going to be a part of it once he gets connected with you, because who they said you were and what they said you were to this individual are doing, it does not add up to who you are when this person is with you. So this person wouldn't dare, this the emperor, your kingdom spouse, kingdom wife, they wouldn't dare belittle you by hanging out with people that spoke so low of you. Do you get what I'm saying? God has spared you. What they've done to other people, when they did this to other people go commit suicide. But you work hard. Look, you didn't stop. You kept this shit going. You didn't give a fuck what nobody was saying, what nobody had to say. You didn't give a fuck if nobody was fucking with you. You would beat everybody up. You didn't give a fuck about anything that was going on, collective. You stayed in your own lane. You stayed in your own zone. Only thing you reacted to was what was coming to you. And I'm getting that, lady, you ain't been reacting to shit. And that's why I look. You've been in your bag. You've been focusing on your bag. Every time something break out or kick off, you think to yourself, how is this making me some money? Wow. You're in your bag. Whoever this is, you then boss the fuck up on their motherfucking ass. You got motherfuckers confused. I've seen somebody in the parking lot running circles, running around their car like, you know how we get excited? As chosen ones, we get excited and run of shoutness. They're running of like confusion, like, whoa, how could this be happening? Like, oh my God, like they're panic attack. They're trying to run off a panic attack. Oh, because their car not starting up because they ain't got gas in that motherfucker and they thinking about you. Okay. Maybe you used to ask somebody for some fucking gas, or somebody stole some gas money from you or some shit. I don't know, but something about gas got somebody exotic in a parking garage. Somebody in the motherfucking in the parking garage running around in circles with their phone in their hand. Queen of staff, queen of coins. And judgment. Now, that's what we gonna leave it at. This judgment on you for them individuals bearing false witness on you. Your whole life, the past of your whole life, wouldn't have even happened or went down the way it went. I'm hearing somebody's career didn't stop, but it was put on pause. Maybe you had a career that was going and you don't really take heed of it or you know, use it nowadays. God put that on a back burner for a reason, because this individual wasn't about to touch that with his negativity. The 15th of December could be significant as well. God wasn't about to let this person touch any of your shit, any of your gifts. So everything that you had going on in your life was put on pause because God didn't want this individual or individuals to mess it up. So right now, when this divine masculine come around, he's or she is going to be the one to supply all of your needs for whatever was stopped. Because look, five steps, I'm getting at somebody, a hairdresser. Somebody could have been a hairdresser. You could have stopped doing hair due to lack of clientele. This person is about to get you a hair salon, get you a booth, a space, a suite, and it's about to be so beautiful. This person is going to promote you on a daily. They're going to come onto your suite on a daily. When you're styling your clients, they're going to come and record you styling your clients, record your clients waiting in the seats, record your clients underneath the dryer, like show how busy you are. Oh my God, like this person is going to promote and be there for you. Like this person is going to rock for you, because this person see like they're damn near the only one that supports you, because they see everyone else around you is hating on your come up. Nobody is trying to support your come up or be there for your come up. When this person sees that you are you're in the best state that you've ever been in since they've known you. This person sees you are in a better state than you've ever been since they've met you. And this person has known you for years. Ace of staff. And we gonna leave it at that. Y'all stay prayed up. Pray over y'all kingdom husband and kingdom wives. Even if y'all don't know who they are yet. Because you don't know how that prayer just saved them. In Jesus' name we pray. I say amen and amen.